Going to the church, gonna get married. Going to the chapel and we're gonna get married.
From Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Congregation, James and Clemmy have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, for you have created joy and gladness, pleasure and delight, love, peace and fellowship. Pour out the abundance of your blessing upon James and Clemmy in their new life together. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts and a crown upon their heads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, awake and asleep, in joy and in sorrow, in life and in death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that banquet where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may please him both in body and soul, and live together in faith and love, may receive the blessings of each other. Amen.
Même celle des anges, si je n'ai pas l'amour, je ne suis rien de plus qu'une trompette claironnante ou une cymbale bruyante. Supposons que j'ai le don de prophétie, que je comprenne tous les mystères et que je possède toute la connaissance. Supposons même que j'ai, dans toute sa plénitude, la foi qui peut transporter les montagnes. Si je n'ai pas l'amour, je ne suis rien.
The wedding of a Christian couple is a time of celebration. So we thank you, loving Father, that the special event that we share today allows us to participate in that happiness. May we be united with Clemmy and James and their families in that happiness as they journey in faith and love on this their wedding day. May the joy of this day enter into their lives, bringing fulfillment and harmony.
We pray that God's blessing will come upon Clemmy and James this day. May they grow in mutual respect and love for one another. And through companionship and prayer, may they enjoy a loving and long marriage, living in truth and believing in you and each other and a secure hope for the future. We pray for the Fitchett and the Coulson families, the parents and witness of the bride and groom, and for all the wider family and friends all gathered today. We thank you for the example of their parents' marriages, and we pray that Clemmy and James will find encouragement and guidance from them. We ask that you will sustain them in the days and years ahead. Lord, hear us.
Thank you. Veteran of many festivals in the 60s, it wasn't a bit like this. When Clem said she was going to have a festival wedding, I said, what clothes are you going to wear? And she said, get dressed as you used to in the festivals. And so I described what I used to wear when I went to festivals, and she went, perhaps not. Then when I described the toilets in Shepton Mallard after 200,000 people used them for 3 days and three nights, it started to go off the idea. Anyway, thank you everyone for coming. Thank you for James, Michael and Kate, Brigitte and myself, everybody for coming along. 4th of September, Thursday 2014, I came downstairs in my house at 6:30 in the morning. And James was sitting in the living room. I'd never seen him at 6:30 in the morning. So I said to him, you're late going to bed. And he said, I've got up to see you, I want to talk. And I said, okay, talk then. And he said, Can you go upstairs and get dressed first? So I went up the stairs. As I was getting dressed, I started to think, oh dear, I think he's going to ask me something. So I came downstairs. I was actually quite nervous. And I sat down with him, and he said to me, I'd like to ask your permission to ask Clementine Hand in marriage. I went, all right. Later on, I thought of all things I should have said, like, it would give me great pleasure for you to marry Clementine. Or, thank you, James. I really appreciate you asking to hand in marriage to my beautiful daughter, and I'm very happy to say you can ask her. I just said, all right. Well, it's interesting, on that Saturday, I went to a party in Putney. Most people, similar age to myself, it's quite a young group actually. Thank you. I mentioned my Thursday morning conversation to a group of the ladies there, and they were children in the 60s like myself, and none of them had had their husband-to-be approach the father to ask for hand in marriage, and they were actually quite sad about it when they thought about it. It seemed as if our generation had revolted against the formality. It was actually quite nice. So we thought it's actually quite good to see romance formalised in this way, ask hand in marriage. And formalisation in a church, an assembly like this, it just brings back romance. I think it's really nice. So, so I think I can speak for everyone in this room wishing Clementine and James a life together full of romance and love that started out with. Could you lift your glasses for the first time, please? Cheers.
Cheers.
Bon. Je suis descendu jeudi 4 septembre. À 6h30, contre le matinée. Je venais de sortir de la douche. James était aussi dans le salon. Es-tu toujours en place à partir de la nuit avant, j'ai demandé. Puis je te parle. Je veux parler avec toi, il dit. Ok, je dis, parle. Allez-vous habiller en premier, il dit. Je suis allé à l'étage. Comme je l'ai habillé, je pensais que la seule raison que James aurait sorti du lit à 7 heures de la matinée était de demander. Oh.
Situation with photos, so Sophie, careful. Thank you very much. It was like May you came in and stepped in, so thank you so much. So late for coming, Stephanie. You're doing a wonderful job. Don't breathe. Also, Gail, with the photos as well. I know you've been taking a few, so thank you for those as well. Merci beaucoup. I'd say, Val, where are you, Sophie?
Give us a wave, we're filming.
There. Hello, thank you for the photos as well. Well done. Who's next? This with that wonderful cake over there. Look at that, that's brilliant. You have supported me through the last few years wonderfully when I've been studying and doing nothing while you've been earning money and paying for me to live. May I also say, I had no idea what you described when you said you had a lacy dress, but I had no idea it would be this amazingly beautiful. You look stunning. Well, you always do anyway. We know that. Where am I now? This is the problem with our rating at 5 o'clock. I can't read now. Oh, there we are. But the last bit of my speech, unfortunately, is getting a little bit serious. Might be a little bit too joking. You are a very humble, caring, compassionate, smart, and selfless person. As many of you know, Clem, you're a nurse. I don't think you can really be a nurse in this country for the money. It's not really there. Clemmy is the most humble and caring person I've ever met. So unprejudiced, it's amazing. And I think a lot of that is down to her parents, who brought her up absolutely wonderfully. She is a credit to you. Liam as well. And you did it right as well, didn't you? You did it right. No, I'm joking. Well, Mum did.
Are you ready? It's a beautiful